Hello guys. When you get bored, you try to stay busy. So in today's video, we will try for the first time, at least myself, to take out the car battery, which is connected also to my LPG system. And hopefully I will not blow it up by trying to recharge it to the maximum percentage by using a simple lab power supply purchased from AliExpress. First, let's take a picture to know exactly how to put it back. Let's take all these tools. And see what we got here. So first I will take the negative off. And I'm trying to figure out if I have to disconnect basically everything from it, or simply take out the negative there. But yeah, I would take everything out. I mean, I don't want to rip anything, so this is connected there also, man. Okay, let's see. Hopefully there will be no sparks. Okay, so this is 8. 10. Perfect. So it's out. Okay, so these were the negative cables. Let's disconnect the terminal also. Okay. Now with the positive. Okay, the negative is off. And you can see how bad the guy that installed this battery connected this this pole, this terminal. Okay, so this I will have to clean. Okay. And now the positive is off. And I'll have to take that out also. That terminal will stay there until I take the whole battery out, and like this. Let's see, I have to remove this also. And yeah, let's not forget the 13 screw. fact, this will have to be cleaned as well. And now for the first time I will take out a battery for me, at least. Connected the power supply to the battery with the plus and minus, and now it's time to connect it also to the power source. Okay, so it's connected to the wall. Let's start the power supply first. So I have preset the power supply to 12.7 volts and 2 amps. Let's put the output in the battery and see what's happening. So right now nothing happens, we're in constant voltage, but we should be in constant current. So yeah, nothing happens. Only when I increase the voltage above 12.7, which is the maximum for this battery, only then it puts some really tiny amps in it. So this basically tells me that this battery really has 12.7 volts in it, so it's really fully charged after 4 years. I will not risk to let it with this voltage over its limits. So this is really quite something. And basically this wraps it up, guys. You can see when I put it back to 12.7, it all goes blank, because it means it already has this voltage. So time to clean everything, all the terminals, and to put it back on the car. Let's see if I can put it back again. So this is how it looks. I've cleaned it as well as I could with sandpaper also. With this one here, the terminals also, they look a lot better. Looks like this will be the hardest part to secure it in place. Thank you. I forgot this. Looks way better. My GoPro battery died out. This is how it looks. I cleaned it and tightened it up as well as I could. Everything is secured, even that socket 13 millimeters down there. This ain't going nowhere. Now the moment of truth. Let's see if the car starts. Thank God, all is well. I will deactivate the auto. Thank you so much for watching. I wish you all the best and take care wherever you are.